Good morning. Today we are going to use the equations of projectile motion to derive the range equation.
Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
Remember, the range of a projectile is defined as the displacement in the x direction when the displacement in the y direction equals zero. And the range equation is the range equals the magnitude of the initial velocity squared times the sine of 2 times the launch angle, all divided by the acceleration due to gravity. All right, let's begin deriving the range equation. Billy, could you please break the initial velocity into its components?
I thought that when we used the range equation, we used the initial angle and the magnitude of the initial velocity. We did not resolve the initial velocity into its components. Isn't that right?
Correct. You do not need to break the initial velocity into its components in order to use the range equation. However, in order to derive the range equation, you do.
Oh, right. My bad, dog. Sine theta equals opposite over hypotenuse. Therefore, sine theta initial equals velocity initial in the y direction over velocity initial. And multiplying by the velocity initial gives us that velocity initial in the y direction equals the velocity initial times the sine of the initial angle. And cosine theta equals adjacent over hypotenuse. Therefore, cosine theta initial equals velocity initial in the x direction over velocity initial. And again, multiplying by velocity initial gives us velocity initial in the x direction equals velocity initial times the cosine of theta initial. But we don't have any numbers to plug into the equations, do we?
That is correct. We do not have any numbers because we're not solving a number problem here. We're actually using all variables because we're deriving an equation. We're deriving the range equation. Bo, could you please list everything we know in the x and y directions?
In the x direction, we know the projectile will move at a constant velocity, so the initial velocity we just found in the x direction, which is the velocity initial times the cosine of the launch angle, is equal to the velocity in the x direction. We're solving for the displacement in the x direction or the range, so r equals question mark. In the y direction, we know the displacement will be equal to zero, and the acceleration is negative 9.81 meters per second squared.
Actually, Bo, we should not use numbers when deriving equations. We should use only variables.
Okay, then the acceleration in the y direction equals negative little g, the acceleration due to gravity.
Bobby, please start solving the problem in the x direction.
What am I solving for? I didn't think we were doing a problem.
Ah, the problem is derive the range equation. So what do you think that we should be solving for in the x direction?
Okay, so we should solve for the displacement in the x direction or the range. We know the velocity in the x direction equals the displacement in the x direction divided by the change in time. Multiply both sides by the change in time to get the x displacement, or the range equals the change in time times the velocity in the x direction.
And we have an equation for the velocity in the x direction. It equals the initial velocity times the cosine of the launch angle.
Yeah, so the range equals the change in time times the velocity initial times the cosine of the initial angle.
Right, so now we have an equation for range in terms of the change in time, the initial velocity, and the initial launch angle. Let's pause now, switch to the y direction, and solve for change in time, substitute what we get back into this equation for range. Billy, could you please do that?
We can use the uniformly accelerated motion equation. Displacement in the y direction equals the initial velocity in the y direction times the change in time plus 1/2 times the acceleration in the y direction times the change in time square. Change in time square. Get it?
I get it, but it's not funny. It's kind of funny.
Thanks, Bo.
Okay, that's a bit weird. Can we get back to the problem, please?
The displacement in the y direction is zero, so the whole equation equals zero. So we can divide the equation by the change in time to get zero equals velocity initial in the y direction plus 1/2 times the acceleration in the y direction times the change in time. Subtract 1/2 times the acceleration in the y direction times the change in time from both sides, and we get the initial velocity in the y direction equals to the negative of 1/2 times the acceleration in the y direction times the change in time. We can substitute in the negative g for the acceleration in the y direction, and the negative cancels out, which means we are left with 1/2 times the acceleration due to gravity times the change in time. And multiply by both sides by 2 to get 2 times the velocity initial in the y direction equals the acceleration due to gravity times the change in time, and then divide both sides by the acceleration due to gravity to get the change in time equals 2 times the initial velocity in the y direction divided by the acceleration due to gravity. Oh, and you can substitute in velocity initial times the sine of the initial angle for the velocity initial in the y direction, and we get that this change in time equals 2 times the velocity initial times the sine of the initial angle, all divided by the acceleration due to gravity.
And now we can substitute that equation for change in time back into our equation for range. And we get that the range is equal to 2 times the magnitude of the initial velocity times the sine of the initial angle divided by the acceleration due to gravity, all multiplied by the magnitude of the initial velocity times the cosine of the launch angle. And we can rearrange it a little bit so it looks like this. The range of a projectile is equal to the magnitude of the initial velocity squared times 2 times the sine of the launch angle times the cosine of the launch angle, all divided by the acceleration due to gravity. And who sees it?
Sees what?
I don't know. Yeah, I'm not seeing what we're supposed to be seeing.
Yeah, that's okay. In this class, generally, we don't require that you remember or even have learned the double angle formula or other trig functions like it.
Double angle formula?
Oh yeah, 2 times the sine of theta times the cosine of theta equals the sine of 2 times theta. I don't think I ever learned that.
Again, you do not need to know the double angle formula, 2 times the sine of theta times the cosine of theta is equal to the sine of 2 theta, in order to use the range equation. We do need it, however, in order to do this very last step in deriving the range equation. We are going to substitute in the sine of 2 times theta initial. The range of a projectile equals the magnitude of the initial velocity squared times the sine of 2 times the launch angle divided by the acceleration due to gravity.
G is positive.
Of course, we all remember that the acceleration due to gravity is a positive number. That is the derivation of the range equation. Please remember, the range is defined as the displacement in the x direction of a projectile when the overall displacement in the y direction is equal to 0. V sub I is the magnitude of the initial velocity, and theta I is the initial angle, or the launch angle of the projectile. And G, of course, is positive. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.